So what is meant by Informatica, first thing? So Informatica is one of the ETL tool. And ETL mean extract, transformation, loading. So where we are extracting the data? So before going to ETL part, what kind of databases we have? Anyone? What are the databases we have?
Echo.
Okay.
Teradata.
Yes, good.
Oracle?
So we, yeah, Oracle, SQL, Sybase, DB2, Teradata, Greenplum, Cassandra, Impala. We have different MongoDB, different databases we have. I want to pick one table from each database and I want to integrate it into any one specific database. Instead of loading each database, if you want to see each table, it will take long time. So instead of that, we can integrate it into any one specific database. So this is one kind of use by using Informatica. But Informatica not only supporting all relational tables, it will get support all relational tables along with XML, flat file, COBOL, SAP. These all are different sources we have. So this all source data, it can be extract all the data. Now we have different sources here. Let us assume all the sources, I have 1 lakh records. Just consider I have 1 lakh records in the sources. Now we are extracting all the data from different sources and then we are pulling into staging nothing but all transformations. So what is meant by transformation? Anyone? Any idea? What is meant by transformation?
Making any changes to the data.
Good. Yeah, that's somewhat okay. Fine. See where we have to implement all the business logics within the transformations. So we have a list of transformations. See each symbol. One kind of transformation. But each transformation we have different aspects we can go for, different ways we can use. They have like individual categories, like one is filter, one is router, one is like aggregator, lookup, expression, store procedure, joiner, normalizer, rank, sorter, source qualifier, XML, Java transformation. They are like the list of transformations we have. And out of all the transformations, we have 4 categories. The first will go for 2 categories. So what are the 2 categories? One is passive, the other one is active. Now source we are having. One lakh records. And then target. So now we have 2 categories, right? What are the 2 categories? One is passive. The other one is active. Anyone knows about these 2? What is meant by passive? What is meant by active?
No.
Go ahead.
I do not.
Okay. Fine. See, 1 lakh records. After loading into target, it should be load the same data. There is no change. Source to target, there is no change. That is called passive. Is that clear?
So there is no filtration, is that what you meant?
And yes.
Okay.
whatever data we have sourced, the same data we are fetching into target. That is called passive. And active means I have sourced 1 lakh records. After loading into target, it should be less than or greater than. There should be a change. Let us assume my source is a table. What is meant by a table? It's a collection of rows and columns. We have to consider only row count. Column level we can increase or decrease, doesn't matter, but only row count, it should be same. In that case, it's a passive. If there is a change in the row count, it is called active. Okay, coming to there, Vikrant is asking, so what will happen if the columns are increased? So I have source. Within the source, we have 10 columns. After loading it to target, it should be 10 columns or 15 or only 5. Doesn't matter. But the row count, say 1 lakh records, if you are loading into target, that is called passive. Only we are considering row count. Column level we can increase or decrease, it doesn't matter for us. So it's a passive only. And active means I have source 1 lakh records. After loading into target, it should be less than or greater than. It's called active. Even though the row, like column count, should be increase or decrease, doesn't matter. Is it clear to passive and active? Any questions you have here? Yes, we can change. There's a right. There is a. So passive, we have column type change. We have column types change. Let us assume we have any, your full name, I have customer name. But target, I want customer first name, customer middle name, customer last name. But source, I have only customer name. But we are increasing the columns, but the row count is same. So in that case, it's a passive transformation. Is it clear? Priya, Vikrant?
Yeah.
Okay. You can use chart also, Priya.
Okay.
Any questions you have, you can unmute, you can ask me. Fine. Now, the other two we have, connected, unconnected. Connected, unconnected. Connected means I have all inputs and outputs. See the diagram. See, I'm receiving input. The extract you can consider as a source. Transformation you can consider as a transformation. Load should be target. See, from source to transformation we are receiving input. For source it's an output. For transformation it's called as an input. And again, transformation sending output. Target is receiving only input. But this active, passive and connected, unconnected, it will applicable only for transformation, not for source and target. If we have input, output, both, it is called connected transformation. Or few scenarios, I have only input, there is no output. Still it's a connected. Or I don't have any input, but we have outputs. Still it's a connected. Three ways. One is, if you have both input and output, it's a connected. Or any one, either input I have, still it's a connected, or output we have, still it's a connected. But I don't have any input, I don't have any output, but I have some data within the transformation, how to fetch into target. That that is called unconnected. So as of now, you should aware about what is meant by passive, what is meant by active, and then what is meant by connected, unconnected. So going forward, we'll go for hands-on. So why it's a active, why it's a passive, and how it's a connected, unconnected. Is that okay? Any questions you have, you can ask me, guys. Is it clear as of now? So what you want, Vikrant? Connected, unconnected, or how it is? Which you want to repeat? Okay. Connected, unconnected. So if you have input, output, both, it's called connected. Or any one we have, either input or output, still it's a connected. But I don't have any input, I don't have any output, but I have some data within the transformation, how to fetch into target, that is called unconnected. So we have, out of all transformations, few as a connected transformation, few as a unconnected, and few as a passive, few or active transformations. So going forward, we'll discuss what are the passive we have, what are the active we have. If you know these all the transformations, we can able to work on Informatica. So this is the key thing of Informatica, all the transformations. Fine. Then coming to target. In target, I have only any database, relational tables, and XML flat file. Now, my client is asking, my source is a table. Target should be either table or XML or flat file. See, I want to load table to table or table to XML or table to flat file. Or we'll go for XML to table, XML to XML, XML to flat file. Similar way, flat file to flat file or file to XML, file to database. Or I'm using one is table, one is XML, one is flat file, one is COBOL, one is SAP, five different sources. But target should be either table format or XML or flat file, any one format we can choose. So this is called ETL process. So any questions so far? Okay, good. Now, the entire ETL process of we are implementing within the Informatica. So in Informatica, we have four client tools. What are the four client tools we have? Any idea, anyone? Informatica client tools, anyone is having idea? Priya, Vikrant,
Powercentre.
Okay, Powercentre. Go ahead, Tersi.
Repository.
Very good. Repository manager.
Mapping designer.
Very good. Yes, you can able to see on the left side. These all are client tools. Good. See, one is a repository. Mapping designer, nothing but a Powercentre designer, workflow manager, and workflow monitor. So these are the four client tools. Out of these four client tools, we are using daily three: Powercentre designer, workflow manager, workflow monitor. If any requirement will go, we'll use these three client tools. So we'll go for one by one. What is meant by repository manager? general term, what is meant by repository? Anyone? What is meant by repository? So it's a storage area. So it can be store all the metadata. So whatever we have done, the other three client tools, like what kind of sources we have, targets we have, and mappings, transformations, and workflow sessions, after creating, where it can be stored? Within the repository.
Oh, okay.
Fine. And we are starting with scratch project. I don't have any repositories. I don't have any project folders. So how to configure, where to configure repositories? We'll go for repository manager. We can configure it. So how means we are receiving from DBA team. So what are the details we are receiving? So what is the repository name? What is the domain? And what is the host name, port number, username, password? These all are details we can receive from admin. Let me show you. So we have development, sit, UAT, production, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
See, like this, we are receiving all the details. See, this is the development. So we have a repository name, and then domain name, host name, port number, username, password. This is the dev. How about SIT? System integration testing. So similar way, we are receiving different credentials. And UAT, user accepted testing. So we have all the credentials. And productions, if we required, they'll provide. If it is not, they won't. But these three we have. We can able to access. So if I don't have any repositories, this kind of details we have with us in the documented. So just we can configure. Go to the repository, we just configure. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes.
Fine. The next one is, after configuring repositories, within the repositories we have list of project folders. If I don't have any project folders, I want to create new project folders. So we have to create. Where we have to create? Within the repository. So we are creating project folders. We are configuring all the repositories. If we can add any repository, or if we can create any project folder within the repository, by default it should be added the other three client tools. No need to add again. The other three client tools. So if we can add or remove the repository, it will reflect on the other three client tools. And once we have done our development part, how to move our all the objects from one environment to another environment. So by that time we'll go for repository manager. Until that, we don't have any work. Just we can configure repositories, create project folders. After creating all our mappings, workflows and all, where it can be stored within the repository. Now we are working on one project. It's completed after 3 months. So after 3 months, we are starting with the other project. And after 2 years, I want to see the previous project details. So where we have within the repository. So we have all repositories in the within the repositories. So that is what a repository manager. The next one, Powercentre designer. So this is the important one. So where we are implementing this entire ETL process within the Powercentre designer. The entire ETL process. This all the transformations where we are implementing within the Powercentre designer. So within the Powercentre designer, again I have five components. So one is Source analyzer, target designer, transformation developer, maplet designer, and mapping designer. So these are the five components I have. Source analyzer, target designer, maplet designer, transformation developer, and mapping designer. The first one, source analyzer. So what kind of sources we have?
Flat file, XML.
Yes. So we have relational tables, XML, flat file, COBOL, SAP. These all are different sources. Let us assume my source is a table. Tables, where it's located?
The database.
Very good. Database is the back end. How about Informatica? It's a middleware tool. Right? So how to import table from database to back end to Informatica, middleware tool. So how to import? For that, we are using source analyzer. So while importing, it will ask, what is the source database connection name, ODBC connection name, and what is the username, what is the password we have to provide. Then it will display one schema. Within the schema, we have list of tables, and we can choose which table you want. Okay. Any questions here? Is it clear? Source analyzer.
So the source analyzer is kind of like setting up an ODBC connection or something along the lines to connect to your source to Informatica, so Informatica can use it?
Yes.
Okay.
So we have one more thing here. If any database we have, like Oracle or SQL or Sybase or DB2, so we have two different connections. One is source database connection, the other one is target database connection. Don't get confused. If you have same database, which are the sources, which are the target, we'll get bit confused. So that we have two different categories. One is source database connection, the other one is target database connection. So we have all inbuilt tables within the source, and target we have to design. That we'll discuss. So but any database, we have two different connections, source database and target database. Fine. See, in the name itself, source analyzer. Analyzer means just we can analyze the data. We have only read access. There is no write access. Because of the same source tables, there is in multiple projects. If we can do any changes, it will get reflect the other projects. So that they won't give any write access. We have always read-only access. Okay. So once we have imported source table, we have all structure, entire table structure along with data we have. And after importing, we'll go to database. We'll check it whether this source table is having data or not. Unless if we can create entire mapping, there is no source data, our entire effort should be lost. So that whenever we can import source table, we can check whether we are having data or not. So if it is not, why it's not having? So we have to escalate it. So we don't have any data. So how to implement this entire requirement? We cannot. Once we have any data, then only we can go for next steps. Is it clear? Source analyzer. Any questions you have? The next one, target designer. So what is meant by target designer? See, in the name itself, we have design. See, if we have any requirement, first we are receiving what is the repository name, what is the project folder name, then what kind of source database and target database, and what is the source table, and the what kind of requirement, what is the requirement we have. So we know what is the source table along with what is the requirement. Based on the source along with requirement, so we have to design target table. Let us assume I have one source, customer table. I have like customer ID, customer name, and customer location, and salary, customer salary, and department number we have. And then I want to load into target table. So I want customer name, length. I want to find out only customer name, length. Along with, I want to go for customer first name, middle name, last name, and then we'll go for cumulative salary also. I want to go for cumulative salary also. So in the source, I have only 5 fields, but target, I want 5 fields along with length of customer name, and then customer first name, customer middle name, customer last name, and then cumulative salary. We are adding additional 5 fields. So total 10 fields. So this 10 fields we have in the source. I don't have. I have only 5 fields. So based on the requirement, we have to design, we have to create target tables. Guys, are you getting?
Yeah.
Target tables, we don't have any target tables. We have to design based on the requirement and based on the source. And we can design multiple ways. So go to database, target database, we can create table, table name. What are the columns we want, we can provide. And once we have created, we can import through target designer. This is the one way. The other way is directly we can create Informatica itself. Then we are generating into database. Both the ways we can do for target. So one thing is directly we can go for database, we can create table, then we can import it. The other way is we can create within Informatica, then we can generate into database. Both the ways we can do. So after creating target table, we have only structure. But source we have structure with data. Both we have. Then how to move data from source to target? For that, we are having, first we have to create our entire mapping. So any questions on target designer? After creating target, we have only structure. Vikrant,
Priya,
okay. The next one, transformation developer. See, transformation developer, maplet designer, both are reusable components. Reusable means the same transformation we can use multiple requirements. Now today we have one requirement. I'm using any one transformation. I have like list of how many transformations we have. There are around like 20 transformations we have. So out of all transformations, we can go for any one transformation as a reusable. We can go for transformation developer. Only one as a reusable at a time. But my requirement is I want to go for more than one transformation as a reusable. In that case, we'll go for maplet. But both are reusable. Transformation developer, only one transformation as a reusable. But maplet, we'll go for more than one transformation as a reusable at a time. And mapping designer, so which is the source we have imported, the same source table we are placing on the left side, and which is the target we have created, we are placing on the right side. Between source and target, we have to use a list of transformations. It's up to business needs. How many transformations we want to place it, and then what kind of logics, if you want to implement, we can implement within the transformations. So after creating mapping, I have source structure with data and transformations we have. Within the transformations, we have implemented all the business logics, and target I have only structure. Then how to move data from source to target? For that, we are using Workflow Manager, the third client tool, Workflow Manager. So this entire PowerCentre designer, we have source analyzer, target designer, transformation developer, mapped designer, and mapping designer. So any questions on PowerCentre designer, guys? Vikrant, what is your question? Difference between maplet and mapping. Very good. Maplet is, first thing is reusable. At a time, we are going to use more than one transformation as a reusable. So after creating maplet, the same maplet we are implementing within the mapping designer. Good. So this base we have and chain we are implementing within the mapping. Even the transformation developer, we are creating within the transformation developer. After creating, where we are using? Within the mapping. The next one is Workflow Manager. So what is the use of Workflow Manager? How to move data from source to target? So based on the integration services. See, here we have under domain, we have integration services. So by using integration services, we are moving data from source to target. The first thing is, we have to create workflow. Within the workflow, we have to create session. Within the session, we have to provide where is my source, where I want to load. If you're not providing any connection details, the job got failed due to where is my your source. I cannot able to find its source. Let us assume my source is a Oracle, target should be a Teradata. So we have to provide the both the connection details. Is it clear? Or my source is a file. Files where it's located? Server. We have to provide the path. Where is my source path? Any questions, guys, here? So once we are applied this all the connections, we have two kind of loadings. One is normal load, the other one is bulk load. So what is meant by normal load? What is meant by bulk load? Any idea? Anyone? Priya? What is the difference between normal load, bulk load? Any idea?
No.
Okay. Others? Vikrant, Tersi. Okay. So normal load means we are loading record by record. I have 1 lakh records. It will load record by record. So it will take 15 minutes of time to complete entire job. Workflow nothing but a job. And if you can go for bulk, at a time bunch of records it will be fetched. So performance wise it is fast. It will complete within 4 minutes. So 15 minutes is better or 4 minutes is better? The performance wise bulk is better, but there are some drawbacks while using bulk load. So whenever we have target is a table, if we have any indexes, it won't allow. First we have to remove the indexes, then it will fetch the data. But normal load, if we have any indexes, still it can be load all the data. And one more thing, I have 1 lakh records. After loading 80,000 records, my job got failed while using bulk load. If we can rerun the job, again it will start from beginning 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But I don't want, I want to start with 80,000 one record. But if we can go for normal load, we have session recovery option. We can use that, it will start from 80,000 one record. But in the bulk load, we are not sure which records it's fetching. It's fetching randomly records. So that it won't work out. So these are the two drawbacks while using bulk load.
So in normal projects, only the normal load will be used, or?
No, we can use bulk load also, but it's completely full load.
Okay.
If you have huge data, there's no option to go for normal load. If you are taking long time, so better to go for bulk load. After creating workflow, workflow nothing but a job. If you can run the job by default, the monitor get open, the last client tool. So what is the need of monitor? Just monitoring the jobs, whether my job is succeeded or failed. If it is succeeded, how many source success rows, how many target success rows. If it is failed, how many source fail rows, target fail rows. If you have any errors. So if still you're not understanding entire flow, we have within the monitor session log. Go to session log. We have detailed explanation. So what is the repository? What is the project folder? What kind of mapping? What is the session? What is the workflow? If job got failed, where is the issue? Either source level, target level, or mapping, or workflow, or session. So we can identify the issues. Then we can go for directly where we have issues, we can fix it. Is it clear? Any questions you have? Vikrant? Mapping used under workflow. Already we have created mapping within the mapping designer. If mapping is valid, then only we can go for workflow. So within the workflow, we have to create session. While creating session, it will ask mapping. Which mapping we have already created? We can select the particular mapping while creating the session. Priya, Darcy, is it clear? Or any questions you have? Okay, good. And then, once my job is succeeded, where we'll check it? Go to target database. We'll write the query. Select star from corresponding table name. We'll check the data. Our expected data is loading or not in the target. Fine. So this is the normal process for any requirement in Informatica. And here we'll cover entire like data warehouse, Informatica, and support like a bit Unix, as well as we'll go for ETL testing also. We'll cover a bit. So we'll go for like now course content entire thing. Now we have to cover data warehouse. So in data warehouse, so what are the schemas we have? Star schema, Snowflake schema, Galaxy schema, and what are the facts we have, dimensions we have, data modeling, data mart, data cleansing, and OLTP, OLAP. These all things we'll cover in the data warehousing part. And then we'll go for Informatica. We'll go for like each client tool, like we have already discussed four client tools in hands on how to go for all those stuff. And then what are the components we have? Each is it like repository or like a Powercentre designer, workflow manager, and monitor? So we can go for in detail. And then what are the transformations we have? So all the transformations one by one, along with real time examples. We'll go for. I'll go for like one example. And then the Informatica we have. All the transformations, and then how to do debugging, how to do error handling, and how to do scheduling. And then we have sequential load, parallel load, how to do this all are we'll cover. And along with, yes, we'll go, that is the last thing, deployment, Vikrant. And then we'll go, we'll having performance tuning, how to do, how to find out bottlenecks. And then we have like partitions in the session level, how to do. These all our topics we'll cover. And then we'll go for ETL testing. So how to prepare estimation document. And then how to create test plan, test cases. How to execute, what kind of testing tools we have. So what is the high level process we have? I'll explain all the stuff. This is not in the course content, but we are adding ETL testing also. But some of the cases, they'll hire as an Informatica resource, but they'll put on ETL testing means Informatica testing. You should work on it. how to connect to the tool. That is important. If you know how to connect to the tool, the entire course should be similar way. The way of the transformations, business logics are different, but they are the way of using and all same. How to connect to the tool and all. The one or two mappings, bit confusing part for you guys. First off, it's simple. Even though we have for that documentation, see, we have how to connect to the tool and all. First, we have to run the services, and then we'll connect to the database. So we have explanation like step by step screenshots also we have. And also, if you want steps how to connect to the tool, we have even steps also. First, we have to run the services, then how to connect to the Informatica tool, then database.
I'm sure you enjoyed learning from this video. Please like the video, and if you have any doubts regarding this video, please comment us in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more information, visit our website now. Keep learning with Intellipaat.